Chapter 6. First, save. The boss fight at the end of the dungeon dealing with her is definitely the best boss fight in the game so far. It really sucks that the stream wasn't working there, because that means I have no record of the Jam and Rock song one of the characters played after I got an electric guitar for him out of a dungeon. Gee, you mean like the chick that was working for him?
How you doing, that stuff?
Okay, so apparently that's not who I'm going to talk to about it. Nope, I'm going to go talk to the adventure. Oh, actually, that reminds me. I need to go talk to the appraisal dude. I got some question mark item. It's called a black disc. I need an appraisal, old man. Appraise. Oh, I got a bunch of things. Okay. Folded cardboard. Appraises. I found a storage box. Okay, how about this damp booklet? A sleazy magazine. That's disgusting. Alright, how about this white furball? This is one of the 5 legendary artifacts? The hair ring fills your focus gauge instantly. What? Useless weapon, appraise. The flexifier with an R. Restricted symbol at the end. And how about that black disc?
It's a record.
You have found the Gandrake Jingle. So yes, it was a record.
Nice.
Wow. That's... Okay, items. I'm curious. Hair ring. A ring that improves focus with jackrabbit speed. Okay. Accessories. Parts. I guess maybe all these blue items in the inventory are just there to be sold, but I'm really not sure. Hey, Shadow.
Oh, hey, Shadow.
Alright, where was I headed? Oh, yeah, straight across to Adventures.
What happens if you say use? It just doesn't do anything?
Yeah, it didn't do anything. Yep, I've got the Void Sword. Easily the coolest looking of all the swords.
I mean, you might as well just sell it.
I'm just gonna play it safe for now. There doesn't seem to be a cap on my inventory, at least not that I've hit.
One of the best, like, quality of life things to happen in video games in the last, like, generation or so is the idea that, like, trash items are just straight up marked trash.
Yeah.
You know? They're just like, look, don't worry about it. You know? Or, like, there'll just be a button when you go to a shop and go to sell that'll just be like, sell all my trash items. So you just don't have to fucking think about it.
1 hour later. Technology!
I
That's one of you.
Working together for your future! We've done it! I present our finest creation yet, the jet board! This is awesome! What is it? It's a jet-propelled vehicle designed to traverse large bodies of water, featuring the latest advancements in water bug technology, with integrated nose hair trimmer. I had you guys all wrong. I took you for a couple of crackpots. This is pure genius. We anticipate positive results, and that's what you'll get. Oh, yeah. There's still some rooms in this thing that haven't been filled in yet. That clearly just have straight up, like, doorways into them, and not, like, damaged sections of the building, like, over there. Actually, before I go anywhere, just refill up on some healing items. Last dungeon is on the money maker of the dungeon, so if I need cash, I can just pop back there in and out of some specific rooms and get a crap ton of money. Alright, you old fart. I got my way over there. Let's do this. Actually, I'm kind of hoping I don't just go straight into it so I can go save my game first. You'd think all the other maidens would have been there for that, too. Not just, for some reason, Clochette just apparently stays in Bannon's office now.
How you do?
Because Clochette was working for the villains the entire game. She kidnapped the princess right before the last chapter, at the beginning of the last chapter. And, but then she got betrayed by Gandrake, who she was working for. I saved her. And after some berating, she's back here where she's originally from this village. Mm-hmm. But the thing, she even admits, like, right at the end that she's a thief at heart, so she just goes wherever there's money, which is why she was with Gandrake.
Huh.
Oh, nope, hold on. There's a star up in front of the dojo. That's gonna be some sort of side quest.
Tell me what happened.
My sweet little Mayday here broke her wing, and now she can't fly. I can't just leave her like this.
You named a bird Mayday?
Good response, Musashi.
Mm-hmm. I've done what I can for her, but she needs ointment. I can't make it for her without the right ingredients, though.
What do you need?
Mushrooms, a rare kind of mushroom that grows in Manglewood. They're used to make all kinds of bird medicines.
Is that so?
I'd need about 3 thrushrooms. Would you go get them for me, Musashi?
Sure thing. I'll head to Manglewood to find that funky fungus for you.
You're the best.
Damn right. Manglewood was like one of the first dungeons in the game, so I'm guessing that now that I've got the Wind Sword and the Void Sword, I can get to somewhere here that I couldn't get to before.
Ah, Musashi.
Oh, that was dumb. Like, literally the direction of the end of the game, not Manglewood, which is... Oh, are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? I can't go back from this location now that I've moved the fucking thing over to it. Which means I literally have to reload the game so I can go do that fucking... Oh, you piece of shit. Really? Why would it even let you do that without some sort of warning that you're not allowed to go back on the map screen?
Yeah, that's... Maybe, like, once the cutscene's over or something, you can go back, but I don't know.
Dolby Pro Logic 2.
From the land of...
Man, that menu jingle. Aw, man. I gotta do, like, so much of that conversation stuff over again. Ugh. Alright. It's not too bad. At least I only have to go talk to him.
A bird.
I just wanted to hear you say that again. Mm-hmm.
What do you need?
Thresh runes.
Is that so?
I need a...
Sure thing.
You're the...
Shit.
Ha!
All right, to Threshwood then. I mean Manglewood, to get Thresh runes.
Ah, Musashi.
Hmm. person to rescue. It was 21,796 money. The money you get out of chests in this game is really, really oddly priced, or oddly like. Like, it's never just 5,000, 100. Like, it's always.
That makes me think that it's probably, like, dynamically generated based on, like, your level. So, like, you know, it's just a math problem. Or maybe it's just, like, randomized or something.
Yeah, I'm thinking so slightly randomized. But yeah, I mean, most likely. It's just, it's really weird to see. I do love coming back to really weird areas with, you know, all my higher level and my souped up gear and just tearing enemies apart. So you do have levels in this game.
Yeah, I noticed that. I was messing around with it a little bit. I'd forgotten how the levels were. You know, you like to
Except you can also choose from what you do at your
time. Yeah.
Which is nice. And I kind of like that, because generally I don't want to do it myself, because I find that somewhat tedious and largely meaningless. So I prefer just having the option of a megaphone of attacking with the better armor with some better stat.
It's like attack, defense,
focus.
Yeah,
the last one. So I was saying it like that in regard, so I wasn't being too specific for this game. There are not that many air styles. At least most of them are fairly distinct from one another. And of course, there's always the option to not see your hairstyle because you're wearing a cat style.
Ha!
Unless they added a whole bunch, I'm going to have to disagree. Did not take me that long to sculpt it. Swipe at you think will always catch me as I try to run away from them. I wouldn't bother attacking these minor enemies, but so I guess I'll go over there now. It's a problem, I don't actually know like where I'm going for this particular side quest.
Thresh rooms.
Say what? It's too dangerous here. You should head back home and leave this to me.
Not a chance. Finding thresh rooms deep in Manglewood is no walk in the park. We need to search together.
Maybe you're right.
Foraging with Musashi, what a treat.
It's like her voice just changed.
Could you carry me, Musashi? I'll show you where to look.
They didn't even come up with a reason this time. She literally was just like, eh, just carry me.
Go west.
You all be dead now. West is this way. Shut up, lady.
Go west.
Ow!
Ha! Oh. Oh. Oh, she's dead.
Thank you. see.
I really wish you didn't need to get close to, like, the money and that health and energy orbs. You should just absorb them. Because you lose them in such stupid ways as a result.
Go west.
Anything for that? What was the point? What have I done? Sonic Selfie. His name is Selfie and he's completely self-absorbed. What about me? What are they gonna call me? So with special guest Musashi the Entertainer? Boo!
Obviously, you have to, like, do something.
Oh, well, yeah. And my guess is that there's probably a ability I have to copy from some enemy somewhere that is the thing I'm supposed to do.
Yeah.
But A, I would have to know it, and B, I'd have to have enough fucking energy to do it. Yeah, I've learned Whirling Dervish, Diving Falcon, Infernal Strike, Angry Hornet, Paralyzing Bomb, Fish Filet, Banishing Blade, and Double Cross. But all of these are learned from enemies.
Yeah. Got far enough in to grab a couple of them.
Alright, well, save, and I guess we'll head for the end of the game. Presumably. Who knows? Might be a fake out, and I've got to revisit every dungeon again or something.
Video games.
Say what?
I just said video games.
Oh, yeah.
Ha! Musashi.
Over the world map, old man. It's actually the end. That kind of sort of surf music. I was expecting that to be like a section where I actually controlled him on the thing.
Yeah.
Because there's been a section earlier where you control him on a motorcycle. Uh-oh. And Gandrake himself. Mr. Big Bad.
Thanks for the warm welcome, Prez!
Hey, Zaka.
Congratulations on making it this far.
I've come for the princess!
Fat chance.
You have no idea what's going on, do you? Your ignorance astounds.
Laugh it up while you can. You don't have long.
And everyone but Gandrake's like, oh shit. But no. Gandrake is the Sephiroth in his cloud. Oh jeez. The fuck was that cannon thing?
Genius. The swooping swallow that was.
A perfect display of form and style.
Ooh, what's that?
This is my prototype Instacarcerator, AK-47. It works like their escape capsules, with one key difference. Anyone left inside these capsules will die.
The kid crumpled like a cheap paper bag.
He is no match for our president.
Take Mycella to the Archnebulus. We will release the fortress and finish this.
Right!
Yes, Mr. Gandrake. It may take her some time to extract enough energy, though.
That won't be a problem. Prepare your divisions. Immediately.
Yes, sir!
It was a pleasure meeting you. Come after me if you like. Why, I'll be disappointed if you don't.
I guess Gandrake just knows he's gonna get out of it.
That son of a... Hold on till I get there, Mycella! Musashi's on the move!
On this beach. Which I'm curious. Can I leave? No?
Ha!
I'm thinking.
Ha!
Might as well check. That was kind of funny. Some coins from the enemy were still on the... Oh, okay. Just keep getting caught off guard by, like, everything. Maelstrom! That's new. Door. Giant fucking door. Actually, I need to switch back to the ore. That is easily the best one for just standard combat. I wonder if in the next room I will need the next sword to solve the puzzle. Actually, it'd be great if the next room was like, nope, now you need to use the wind one, and not the fire one, which is the next sequence.
Hey, Yukio.
What?
I'm gonna go to bed.
Ow.
Okay.
You should probably actually get on tomorrow so we can do stuff.
Hey, man,
how you deal with everything. A gargoyle gold? A celestial special. dust up the tanks. Interesting. I was expecting there to be like a chest over here or something. I bet those are like really two combos. Some time, but I did get all my energy back, most of my health back, and now there's nothing down here that can screw me up if I mess up getting across the thing. Ha! there's supposed to be a lever? I got the lever. Okay. And of course, everything here is respawned. Looks like the lever could go here. Nah, that'd be too easy. That doesn't really make a lot of sense. All the bosses again.
Well, what
Well, look what the cat bragged in.
We have a cat?
No way am I losing to you two.
Wow. And Musashi's just like, you two are the stupid ones. You don't even have a chance.
You're a feisty bloke, aren't you?
Yeah, you're what he said.
Listen, don't get the idea we're paired up because we like each other. He's obviously denser than a nugget of nebulite. Frankly, I can't stand the sight of him. Why, if I had my way, I'd wipe that idiot grin off his mug permanently. But as a team, we never lost. And I doubt
Except
we ever
right
will.
Now.
Hey, look who's talking. That's like the pot calling the kettle back. But you're right about the us not losing part. Okay, Musashi. We're gonna kill you so dead, you'll wish you were never born alive.
Wow. Oh. Oh, okay. What the? If I had had an inkling of what the fucking fight mechanics were gonna be, that would not have happened. Oh, that didn't actually do any damage, are you kidding?
You like that?
Huh?
like that?
Ha! Ha! Yeah, just trying to get away from them. Thanks, game. Back into the wall. Virtually impossible it is to actually just avoid enemies. Shit. Great. Wow! Fuck you! Look at this bullshit! Am I just infinitely respawn? Subhuman insult, that was good.
Yes, I have no qualms about devouring you.
The calcium is good for my nails.
He actually just straight up says he has a tail. Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm famished. I think you'll hit the spot.
Is he being metaphorical or... A much nicer fight than the last one. None of that waiting around bullshit. Just an actual fight. is way better than that.
Hang on. I'll get you out.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
I see you made it past the buffoon.
I'm warning you! Out of my way!
Hoping to save the princess, are we?
Yeah.
If so, I believe we can arrange an equitable exchange.
A what?
Give me the 5 swords. I will release the princess.
Don't tell me he's actually gonna fucking
now
do that.
That sounds like a fair trade, doesn't it?
So, the deal is, you get the swords, and I get the girl.
Or, better yet, we join forces. How does that sound? Together, we could overthrow Gandrake. You stand no chance against him alone. Neither do I. But with 2 of us, and the swords, victory is within reach. You can rescue the girl at your leisure when you're free.
2 against 1? What a wuss.
I prefer the term strategy.
But I'm not going to deny that I'm basically a pussy coward.
Rising through the ranks here requires an appreciation for certain tactics.
And makes backstabbing a breeze!
Backstabbing? I'm already next in line. I'm simply expediting the inevitable. Perfectly reasonable. Now, I'll ask you once more. Will you join me?
No, but I will kick your butt! Cowards like you need to be taught a lesson. And I'm the guy to teach it.
It seems I overestimated you. Ah, what a pity. Clearly, you fail to recognize the potential of this opportunity. So be it. But before you die, no less. My son is infusing the Arch-Nebulous with her magic even as we speak. Generating enough energy to launch our fortress into the skies. Our powers are astonishing. Your little princess will serve us well after you are gone.
That's it! Break out your books! School's in session!
You just don't understand. I will have the swords, one way or the other.
Or another. I'm gonna get them. I'm gonna get the swords. Ah! Oh! Okay, got a run. Is there seriously nothing I can do about that? Seriously, what is this bullshit? Why can't I outrun that? How else am I supposed to deal with it? Just no end quote, no nothing. Just wham! Get the fuck out. Oh, come on. This was so a dupe to get the fucking swords. Thank you. else would it be?
Sorry I took so long, Princess. Let's get you out of here. Are you all right?
I'm fine. I guess this is the third time you've had to carry me.
Yeah, I should start charging by the pound.
You're terrible.
Just trying to make a living. Sorry, couldn't resist. Think you can stand?
I think so. Oh, I'm sorry. Would you mind carrying me?
You know, at least they could have had him, like, stand her up and then she falls down and then asks.
Yeah, I love a good workout.
Thanks. Trapped in there, not knowing when help would arrive, I was so frightened. But I always believed you'd come for me, and here you are. I'm so happy. I have a favor to ask.
Sure, name it.
Promise me you'll make it. Gandrake's powers are truly terrifying.
Yeah. No. Okay. No dying. I promise. We'll both get back to Anthium in one piece.
Great. I'll now cast a spell to ensure your victory. You better close your eyes.
Sure. Let her rip. Hey! What was that?
Oh, that was the spell of certain victory.
You sure?
Absolutely.
Okay. That was cute. The hardest thing they could have done was this. They made the kick for carrying something real powerful.
Ah!
Nothing happens ha! Right in the...
Ha!
None of the can. Everything but circle. I don't understand. What am I supposed to do? Why is the elevator not going down? The other swords, so I can't do a ground pound or something. I got nothing, guys. I don't know what to do. I was supposed to go through that door. Are you kidding? I had to walk up to it and hit X? None of the other doors in here have been like that. Right after I said something. I swear to God, it's like the game went wait, he's too far ahead. Slow him down. Yeah, get the girl out of here. I don't give a shit. I just want to fight you.
You're late, Musashi.
Oh, and they have to. They've got to have a throw to the actual legend of Musashi Miyamoto.
I think we'd ever repeat those words. Fate is strange indeed.
You lost me.
Shall I spell it out for you? We are from the same world, you and I. I was a samurai named Ganryu. Our destinies are bound together, though you seem unaware of it.
Wait, I remember that name. It was once an honorable one.
Do you wish to go home again, Musashi?
Well, yeah.
I once did too. But after a fateful encounter with the Arch Nebulus, all became clear. I knew what had to be done.
Which was?
Nebulite makes this world go round, and every chunker traces back to the Arch Nebulus. With my innovative Nebulium engine, I built this company up from nothing. We needed power to make this world a better place.
Oh, please, spare me the sales pitch.
It was all thanks to him, the Arch Nebulus.
Excuse me?
Yes, the Arch Nebulus has a mind of his own, but you'd never understand.
I knew you were nuts, but talking rocks? They sing and dance, too?
Predictable. You see, the Arch Nebulus is a higher form of life, with an intellect vastly superior to our own.
In another mech-based universe, it's known as Metatron.
Wills merged. A union of souls, as it were.
Drove another motherfucker nuts
now,
there, too.
We think and act as one. With Mycella and the swords in our grasp, we want for nothing. We now form a single entity, evolving ever closer to omnipotence. One life to rule all others.
I'm sure you make a lovely couple, but think of the children.
We will purge the world of its impurity. It shall be built anew through our newfound power. Of course, we may require further assistance from your mystics.
Ha! Who would even think of helping you?
We will do the thinking for everyone.
Bad feeling I'm gonna have to die at least once to figure out the ow.
Ha! 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 Ha!
Ha! Oh, that was yeah. His sword looked funny because it was in the middle of swooshy animation.
Hmm.
trying to move. And she moved away from where I was running to. So much for that healing. Yeah, bet everything he's about to do is bullshit. Lady, stop! Ha. 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 It was polite of the game to give me all the swords back like this. Fight, dude. The amount of healing she did was completely inconsequential.
Ah!
You just pissed off the hero.
You'll pay for that! You'll pay with your life!
Don't piss off heroes!
Even if I go down with you!
Silence! No more games! Prepare yourself for the first step toward a new world!
Hash that one out in Sonic Adventure 2. Gandrake nebulized. Whoa, he big. Oh boy. Now. Okay. Try to attack it afterwards. I have learned many things. Nuts. And the nuts again. ma'am. Oh, bullshit. Damn it. Okay, what the balls am I supposed to do about the laser? Seriously. Don't fucking anybody answer that. But he can back up off the fucking... So much to great. I love how that didn't hit me last time, like it shouldn't. This time doing the exact same thing, it didn't work. I actually don't really have that much in the way of healing items. Not if I keep taking this much damage. What to do about a lot of these attacks. I really genuinely don't know what to do for a lot of these. And look how much damage that does! That nothing has health bars, or well, bosses don't. At least I can't. It doesn't seem like I can lock on, so I can't try to judge if he does. Since you can judge something's health when you lock onto it. Oh, I love how I did nothing different and suffered anyway. Nothing different got hit. Nothing different. Nothing. No idea. Was that it?
How could I have let this happen? Forgive me.
Please. Do not blame yourself. There is nothing you could have done. It was fate.
Just a little ham on the yelling. Oh, the cat doesn't seem too upset. That's what happens when you're not given enough facial expressions.
Maybe not, Musashi. Give her to the Anthedon.
You mean...
Merciful Anthedon! My Cella lives once more!
Oh my... I'm back! Uh-oh. Thanks.
Well... Welcome back!
Come, come! So much to prepare! We shall have celebrations, victory parades, and assorted...
Who talks like that?
Not too shabby, little firefly.
I'm so happy, Master.
Oh, you call me Master. Huh, you give fat promotion to Mr. Doom.
Fat cat deserve fat promotion.
This is a Scooby-Doo episode. Everyone's laughing at the end over a lame joke.
You've got to be kidding me!
Musashi, we settle this now.
Like, actually? Like, gameplay?
Not again! Oops. Everyone, stand back!
Thank you.
Get going! Move!
No, you will see this through, come what may.
All right, if you're sure.
We believe in you, Musashi. I'm frightened, but I'm staying.
You'll be all right. Right, Musashi? Of course. He's Musashi after all.
I know you can do it. Focus!
Disembowel him! Dead.
Please, Musashi, come out alive. Believe in yourself. If anyone can do it, you can.
Is it actual gameplay or isn't it?
Thanks, all of you. Don't worry. I won't let you down.
Now we fight to the death.
Is that a promise?
This time, I mean it.
What? I don't remember what the button is! I don't remember which button it was for learning abilities. Was it circle? Shit. Wow, I really killed the dramatic end of the game by not remembering how to play. Like, I haven't tried copying an ability in forever. Okay, it's not circle. I tried square the first time, but maybe I didn't. Wow. If I'd gotten this on the first attempt, this would be so much better. Like, I like that it's interactive, don't get me wrong, but... That was... abrupt, sort of. Not really abrupt, but very... very sharp ending, I guess. One swing of the sword. That is the legend of Musashi. Everything else was a build-up to that swing. Killing Gandrake. I didn't rescue everybody. I'll probably have to go back and see about finding all the other people I haven't rescued. Oh shit, I wasn't paying attention to the credits. There's something, now that I think about it, here at the very end, during the credits, while looking at these pictures, it occurs to me that this art style looks like the art style from The World Ends With You. Like, it's that extremely stylized Gainax did the animation. It looks like what's-his-name style. God damn it. Kingdom Hearts dude! The guy everyone thinks is Final Fantasy, but he's only sort of Final Fantasy. The opening theme was Samurai Struck. I wonder if that had lyrics and I just didn't notice. Stop being stupid. Stop it. What's his name? I can't remember his name. Tetsuya Nomura. Executive producer Yoichi Waida. I've seen that name a bunch. I wonder if that's just because it appears on everything Square Enix. Because I think he's the... It's like seeing Sitaro Iwata's name on stuff. Well, on modern stuff. Oh. They're going to send me home. The end.